हेलो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ द 12th क्लास फिजिक्स, दिस इज़ योर लास्ट वीडियो एंड वीडियो नंबर 18 फॉर योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर इलेक्ट्रिकल चार्जेस एंड फील्ड्स। सो फार वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरियस थिंग्स, व्हाट आर चार्जेस, व्हाट आर फोर्स इलेक्ट्रिकल, व्हाट आर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड्स, व्हाट इज़ इलेक्ट्रिक डाइपोल मोमेंट, व्हाट इज़ इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स, व्हाट इज गॉस थ्योरम, okay student, and what are the application of Gauss theorem. On the application of Gauss theorem we discuss three main headings which was present in the earlier video. In this video I am going to tell you about the very interesting thing which will come in examination and will be used later in physics chapter of this 12th class physics. Torque acting on electric dipole placed in uniform electric field. You know torque, it is the concept of 11th class. What is electric field? I told you earlier in this what is electric dipole? I'm going to tell you one more time. You know torque, you know electric dipole based in uniform electric field. You know electric field, what is uniform electric field? Which is same everywhere. Okay, so I'm going to read it one more time for you. Torque acting on electric dipole placed in uniform electric field. Let us consider an electric dipole of dipole moment P. Since you know student, every dipole has dipole moment P. And the direction of dipole moment is from minus charge to plus charge, as I will show you in figure number X, which is in the next page of this video. So I'm going to read it one more time, student. Let us consider an electric dipole of dipole moment P vector in uniform electric field E. This is your E vector, since electric field is a vector quantity. In figure X, where is figure X? I'm going to show you in the next page. Okay. This is your page. What you are seeing in this figure, I am going to show you original video. This is your electric dipole. You see two equal and opposite charges, plus Q and minus Q, are separated by distance 2A. See in the original video, 2A. Okay. There is electric field lines which are parallel, means they are the electric field in this region is uniform. So whatever the value of electric field here at A where plus Q is placed, same at B where minus Q is placed, as you can see in this figure X. So I'm going to show you one more time. The plus Q at A will have same electric field E, and minus Q at B will have same electric field E. Okay, what is the force acting on plus Q is QE. What is the force acting on minus Q? It is QE. From where this is coming, I am to show you, because it was the part of earlier concept of this chapter. What is the formula of electric field? Electric field is force upon charge. So charge would be what? Charge would be, as you cross multiply, Q into this QE you are seeing in the figure. Okay, look one more time. This is QE. Plus Q, electric field, and minus QE, the electric field is there, but the force would be here. Okay, minus charge, the electric field acts oppositively. So I'm going to read it one more time, where symbols have their visual meanings. Force acting on plus Q, as you can see here, F1 is plus Q. Okay, so come to the next page, student. I'm going to the next page. Force acting on minus Q is F2 minus QE, where you can see, I am going to show you, look at this figure. At minus Q, the force acting is QE, the direction is opposite to this Q1, so minus charge is present in F2, as you can see in your mathematical part. The force acting on minus Q is F2 equal to minus QE, that is your equation number 2. So we have two forces. One is plus QE, which is present in equation 1, you see, and another one is minus QE, you see in equation number 2. So net force acting on electric dipole F is equal to QE minus QE, it would be 0. So you can say in uniform electric field, no net force acting on electric dipole. This formula or this heading has been asked by CBSE so many times. So take the close look of that, and I'm going to show you further. It is clear from figure X that two equal and opposite forces will create torque. What is two equal and opposite forces? First, I'm going to show you here. Suppose there is a particle and this is your force F, and this is your force F. So these two forces are equal, F, but opposite to each other. So if this midpoint is pivoted, so it will start rotating. So this rotational force is known as torque. This is the concept of 11th class, but I am going to show you one more time. Okay, so this is an object AB, to equal and opposite force acts on it, and if any point is pivoted, then it will start rotating. This rotational force is torque. Okay, so I am going to read it one more time after reminding the 11th class what was the torque. It is clear from figure X that two equal opposite forces will create torque. Then what? Come to the next page. Yes, as we know from 11th class, torque is equal to tau force into lever arm. What is lever arm? Lever arm is the perpendicular distance between two equal and opposite forces. You can see here in figure. Yes, this one is the force and this one is the force. So these are two equal and opposite forces. The perpendicular distance would be AC. Okay, this is your lever arm. AC is your lever arm. See one more time. This AC is your lever arm because two equal and opposite forces separated by this distance. Okay. So I'm going to read it one more time. It is clear from figure X that two equal and opposite forces will create torque. Then come to the next page. Torque tau is equal to force into lever arm. Tau is equal to Q into AC. AC is lever arm. I told you earlier. What is sine theta? Come to the figure. Sine theta is perpendicular AC upon 2A. Okay. So come to your mathematical part. Sin theta is equal to AC upon 2A, so AC is the lever arm, 2A sin theta. I will put the value here. So what would be torque? Torque would be from equation 4 and 5, we have QE, same as AC value is from here. Okay, so look at the original video. QE, 2A. Sin theta, on rearranging we have 2aq, which is dipole moment, e sin theta. Torque is equal to p cross e. So this is the required expression of torque acting on electric dipole in uniform electric field. Okay students, so come to the next page. There's a note. Okay, what is solid angle? I am going to define it mathematically. You should know only the mathematical formula of this. What is the use of this? You will understand in the higher classes. But this is present in the NCRT, so I am going to explain it. Solid angle, as you are seeing this one, these two lines are not representing two-dimensional figure. It is actually representing three-dimensional figure. A kind of cone is formed there. Okay, so this angle is your solid angle and this area is ds, your rs, whatsoever we take. Okay, so look here one more time. This is three dimensional cone and this angle is your solid angle. So what is written here? I am going to read it one for you. Note one, solid angle concept is very important in figure Y. You see there are two different areas, B1, B2 and small areas also. So if we want to define this one, we have to take area upon radius square. Come to the next page. Yes, this one. But student, you just keep focusing on the mathematical formula. If you want to calculate the solid angle, which is 3D, then it is defined mathematically as delta ohm is equal to delta s upon r square, area of the cone upon radius square. And if it is not small, not delta, if it is ohm, solid angle, then s by r square. So these are the mathematical definition of solid angle. So student, what we did in this video, we finished your last heading, not according to NCRT, but according to my ending strategy. This is your last one. This I'm going to tell you, torque acting on electric dipole placed in uniform electric field. What is the formula of that? This one, net force was zero. So if CBSE asks to you what is the net force acting on electric dipole in uniform electric field, what is the value of force? This is the value of force. No force acting, zero force acting. And if CBSE asks what is the expression for torque acting on electric dipole in uniform electric field, then tau vector is equal to P cross T. This is your required expression. And after that, I explained you an important concept which is defined mathematically, which will be asked in the later classes and may be asked as a mathematical definition of what is solid angle. This is your solid angle. What you found mathematical definition? Yes, area upon radius square, area upon radius square. Okay, students. So in this video, we completed your first chapter. And this is your end of your video number 18 and this video and chapter 1. And in the next videos, I will be going to explain you what is the second chapter. And before that, I will also provide you the worksheet on the chapter 1 with solution.